r/AskReddit by Reddicle. Serious, what was something you saw you were definitely not supposed to see? My severance check. Apparently someone at the payroll company addressed it to me instead of HR, opened it at my desk and laughed, packed up my shit and left. So those reports you wanted at the end of the day, yo, I decided I didn't want to do them. Also thanks for the severance check. I found a letter between my parents back when my dad was in the army 10 years before I was born. When cleaning out the house, he was saying how they should get a divorce because it just wasn't seeming to work out. When I was 16 they did end up getting a divorce. I've never talked to them about it. Edit. Phrasing. Leaving work late one evening. I saw the HR director and CFO in a dark office shredding papers. No, that's not an euphemism. I didn't say anything but quietly walked on down the hall. 2 weeks later we were raided by the second. Several people were charged with cooking the books. Back in 1997, I started work at a new job and took over the office of a salesman who had recently been fired. I was in IT, using the same computer that had been set up for sales. My first task was to install all the software I'd need. The computer hard drive was almost full, so I poked around and found a ton of folders filled with porn. Went to my supervisor, and he said to delete it, warning me that the salesman had been fired for downloading porn. Over the next few weeks, I kept finding secret porn folders onto the company's network. Not only had he downloaded enough porn to max out his computer's HD, he had the network at about 90% capacity. When I was done deleting all the folders I could find, the server capacity was less than 50%. Dude was seriously addicted to porn. I worked at a computer store in the late 90s and was always going out to contract sites to reinstall Windows when an employee left was let go. I'm surprised they wouldn't wipe and reinstall Windows on this desktop after firing someone. Worked for a downtown metropolitan hotel for a long time, and I've seen a lot I wasn't supposed to see. Probably the worst was a kid with an old man. Check this guy in at like 1 in the morning, not uncommon because people travel to different times, but he was alone. Like an hour later he asked for something like a towel or blanket. Anyways, dispatched our runner to deliver it. After the runner comes to me and says he thinks something is wrong because he caught a glimpse of someone and the old guy was trying hard to block the entrance. Being that we were supposed to take stuff like human trafficking seriously, I asked our maintenance to cut his power so we would get a call to come up to try and fix the problem. He doesn't. I go up with him to apologize for the inconvenience because the guy was also a Tortea member. Sure enough, we hear a kid in the bathroom hiding. Tried to ask who the kid was and the old guy tried everything to shut us down from throwing his status around to bribing. Called the cops and let them deal with it. Edit. Didn't expect this to gain so much traction. Here's are some additional info for people that have been asking. I don't recall the specific charge, or if I was even told so. Use your imagination. I don't know the age of the child. I only saw him briefly one time when the cops showed up. I don't know the age of the guy. This was in Southern California, as specific as I'd like to be. Did you end up finding out what the story was? Sort of. I had the next 2 nights off. Was called in my last day to meet a detective to take my statement with HR and a lawyer from the hotel chain's legal team. Talked to the cop a bit afterwards, and she told me to just kinda keep quiet about it all because I could be called to testify if there was a trial. Never ended up getting called, but for a few months I would run the old man's name through our in-house system to see if there were any company notes on his account. Took like 2 months, but his status was revoked and his name popped up on our DNR. Do not rent list. So didn't learn specifics, but learned it was bad enough for me to talk to cops and be prepared to testify if needed. Just 2 days ago, at a community pool, a teenage couple who entered into the pool area went into the hot tub, stood up to stretch my legs and looked over too. Well, sex in the hot tub. It was midday. I cringed pretty hard, but I laughed even harder when the neighborhood cop showed up. Hot tub sex is a bad idea. That water is filled with chemicals and no good for the vagina. Sex in any pool of water is no good. The water takes away any lubrication, natural or synthetic. Shower sex, on the other hand. I once arrived early to pick up a girl for a first date. She was renting a small garden apartment behind a bigger house. It was just after dusk and I walked around the corner. The sliding door was standing open and she was inside walking around, brushing her hair, wearing only her underwear. She did not see me, so I just walked back around that corner and waited another 10 minutes. When I walked round again she had a dress on. I never told her, edit, since a few asked, the date went well. I only got to see her underwear again several weeks later. You have to be careful later when she asks, want to see my underwear? That you don't say, I already have. Thanks. I was downloading a game on my uncle's computer. So I was looking for the files to complete the setup and I clicked on a file called games. Few videos popped up, so the curious girl that I am, I clicked on one and there was it. A Chinese girl literally ducking her couch. That was my first porn experience. I was 7 and my sister was 5. And it doesn't stop there. We decided to show our mom. I'll never forget the trauma on her face. When I was about 16, I was snooping in my parents' wardrobe. Found a diary written by my mother when she was 14. From the year 1970. Read some beautiful and brilliantly written entries about meeting and dating my dad, who was 16 at the time. Had to read a little between the lines in some slightly later entries as they were written with such flowery language. In one such entry, all of a sudden she discloses that she's had an abortion, performed by my grandfather, an anesthesiologist. She never told anyone. I was in elementary school playing basketball. I shot the ball but it ended up going over the fence. On the other side was someone's backyard. My teacher requested that after school I knock on the door of the house where the ball had landed to get it back, and so I did. I did not expect a woman wrapped in a towel with one of her nipples revealed to answer the door. I was shocked but carried on with my mission. For those wondering, she stated she did not have the ball. David Copperfield Show. I was at an angle that allowed me to see the volunteers running out from the stage during a disappearing act. I caught a bully throughout to get an audience participant, and since apparently I was too young at the time my mom went up, she was one of like 8 volunteers. He went down the line and gave them all envelopes. All of them were told to think of a number. He then instructed them to say the number they were thinking and then opened the envelope which had a number written inside. Every single one was right. Couldn't ducking believe it. She said she had no idea how and acted amazed. I did some magic and knew how most tricks were done or had a general sense of how they worked, but seeing one like this dumbfounded me. I figured when they did shit like that on TV it was all paid actors, but it was my mom so it had to be real, and I for the life of me could not fathom it. 10 years later that show got brought up. My mom says, oh yeah, no, he just told us all what number to say. What incentive did she or anyone have not to turn him into a laughing stock right then and there? Was there a reward after the show? Or was there a time in history when trolls did not rule the earth? I found a suitcase full of dildos under my mom's bed when I was 8. I don't know why, but I imagine this as being a fairly large suitcase, actually full of dildos. Like, a few dropped onto the floor when you opened the lid, and you have to keep them from popping out as you try to close the suitcase up again. My Phil sent a dong pic to my wife on accident. Yes, his own daughter. Luckily, I picked up a phone first and saw it. I was so confused at first and then realized what happened and started dying laughing. It was his shaft and there was an Old Spice deodorant stick hiding the head of his penis, and the caption read, "Is this what you want?" As soon as I laughed, she came over and the phone rang. It was her dad calling. I threw it at her because there was no way in hell I could answer it and not be cackling. Poor guy was crying and apologizing, and she said she had no idea what was going on but would delete the picture before even looking at it. She got off the phone, deleted the pic, and then was mortified when I told her. It's my favorite family story. She wouldn't let me get him an Old Spice deodorant stick for Christmas. Back when I was a teenager, we hosted a New Zealander at our house for a couple weeks. Guy gets to our place after the flight, and about 10 minutes later I'm walking around my house to see where he's at. The door to his room is partially open, and the dude is laying face down on the bed and humping the ever-loving duck out of a pillow. I backed away slowly like Homer when he saw Apple cheating on his wife. I felt bad for the pillow. Edit. For all of you asking, no, it was not a wool pillow and it didn't resemble a sheep. As a New Zealander, I apologize to you and the pillow. What the actual duck? my mom gave me an old laptop of hers when I was about 13 and I was scrolling through random pics she had left on it of my little brother's football games and then boom. Nudes of my mother. Around 3 years ago I met my wife's, then GF, mother. She was scrolling through pics she wanted to show me of my wife and then boom. Her titty pics. She had had reduction surgery. She was embarrassed but we all just joked about it. Bonus story. I've also seen her sister scantily dressed for her profile pic of some odd sex stuff she's selling. And that was on purpose. My wife was there. Bonus story. My wife accidentally painted the word dildo on my mill bed. So I guess we're somewhat even. Years ago a colleague had an old smartphone that he brought in to give to another co-worker as theirs broke. The phone was sitting on the new owner's desk but she hadn't yet tried it out, as it was still charging after months of not being used. We were talking about how cool it was with the co-worker. Smartphones were not widespread yet, and I picked it up to see how it felt in my hand. I pressed a button and the first thing that I saw was a Google search for lump on anus. I quickly put the phone back down. This must have been the last thing he searched for when he last used it a long time ago, and forgot about it. Borrowed my dad's camera. Found out he was gay. I love the simplicity of this comment. I do not possess the necessary linguistic capabilities to properly elucidate the gravity of the experience. When I was 11 I walked into my mum's bedroom and saw my mum and her husband doing a 69. We never spoke about it. Years later when I was 24 she walked into my bedroom and saw my BF naked with a boner. We never spoke about that either. My dad's AA chips. Learned it's why my parents got divorced. Proud of him for being in recovery though. Me and a friend snuck away from a house party at 2 a.m. once. We wanted to go to this local abbey. We were exploring the grounds and generally having a nice time when we see two cars stop nearby. Instinctively we hid in some bushes and witnessed what was clearly a large drug trade. We definitely were not supposed to see that. We waited for them to finish their business and then we headed back to the party. My camp counselor's penis. Lock the bathroom door, buddy. I found invitations to my big surprise 18th birthday just lying on the floor a few weeks before the event. I had to act surprised when the time came to walk through the door to the party, which I did. The only thing is, my twin brother also knew, which I didn't know at the time. And let's just say his acting skills are really bad. So we both found out in different ways about the surprise party but neither of us knew that we found out about it. So when I walked through the door for the surprise, I could tell from his reaction that he knew. I like how you're so confident that you sold it but could immediately tell that your brother was faking it. I bet he has a similar story about knowing you were faking lol twin powers. We'll never know which twin wrote this. Happened to a friend of mine. She was dating this dude forever. They broke up and he moved out. She was devastated. About a month later she was cleaning out old stuff and found a receipt for a ring that he had bought for her and never given her. That's how she found out that he had once intended to propose. Before he fell out of love with her, she was hurt pretty bad about that. That happened to me. I can tell you it isn't a lot of fun for the guy either. The day I returned that ring was not great. Thanks for watching this Reddicle video. Subscribe for the best Reddit videos straight to your feed.